us more about the house you grew up in. Now, to answer that, I have to ask you to bear with me. I have to start with my grandparents. My granddad, he was a rough young agnostic, and then he converted. He went to Stellenbosch and became a pastor, passionate evangelical, preaching the gospel. And his wife was almost 10 years older than him. She toured for the Christian Student Association in South Africa. She led many people to Christ. She wrote 3 books, including this one on prayer. And she started the Indian mission in South Africa. She went to India. She sat next to Mahatma Gandhi. She had a passion for lost souls. So many pastors in the Dutch Reformed Church I know of came to faith through her ministry as well. And my mom grew up in that house. My mom was a very rebellious teenager. She had a dramatic conversion experience, my mom. And my mom married my dad, who was a soldier. He was a Christian soldier. And they loved the Lord. And ever since we were kids, we would pray for missionaries. Each boy, we're 4 brothers, had a file with 25 missionaries. And every morning, 6 o'clock, my mom would put on some music and we would all go to their big king-size bed and kneel around the bed, and then we'll fall asleep, and then she'll wake us up, and then you'll pray for 5 of your missionaries. So mom and dad were, they were quite unique at that point. We lived in Pretoria, but there was a passionate zeal for lost souls, for the gospel, to share it with other people. Then we visited my grandparents sometimes. In their last parsonage was in Dispatch, and I'll never forget it. We would go at night, kneel around the bed where our granddad would put our grandmom in bed. She had Parkinson's. He cared for her for several years. And then he would kneel. He would take off his black glasses and he would pray for us. He would preach at us. And I remember one day I fell asleep on the bed and my mom woke me up. I'm getting emotional about it again. And when I looked at my grandfather, the tears were dripping down his cheeks on his, from his chin onto the bed. And when I woke up, I just remember him praying with passion. If I have passion, it goes back to them, really. Tears in his eyes, praying for the African tribes in South Africa and the Afrikaners, and that his grandchildren will all convert and become Christians. So I come from an evangelical, reformed family background, and that had a tremendous impact on my life. I'm one of 4 brothers. We had a Christian band. We toured South Africa. We toured with some American. Stephen Curtis Chapman came at some point. We toured, and then we split when my eldest brother got married, and we went off to university. So that's a bit more about my family background. What were some of your experiences growing up in South Africa, and how did you handle issues like apartheid? That's a big, big question. I think my family was quite unique in that in the early 1980s, my mom on a Friday night, now listen, we lived in Pretoria, a sort of the bastion of Afrikaner nationalism, and on a Friday night, my mom would go into the black township with our minivan and bring 2 dozen black students to come and have coffee and crisps with us, and we would pray together, fellowship together on a Friday night. We had a sleepover in one of the black townships where I got a black name. We learned black songs. My one brother speaks all the African languages in South Africa. So we did grow up in a very interesting house where we were trying to be colorblind from early on. We were ostracized and vilified among the Afrikaners because of that, but that was born not out of social justice, liberation theology. It was born out of a deep conviction of the authority of Scripture, bound and founded on the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.